Good morning and welcome to worship. Welcome back. It's good to see everybody's face here, and I look forward to seeing you all online as well. A couple of announcements to get us started this morning. One, we want to remember in prayer Dolores Oakley to recovering from surgery. We still want to remember Mr. Bobby with his recovery. Ms. LaRue King has a health concern, and Mr. Robert Keith and Linda Blankenship recovering from surgery as well. So we want to remember those as we keep them in our prayers this week as we go. We want to also remember that we have offering now for four different ways. You can go to the church website and give online. You can drop it off at the church office. You can mail it in. And now we can even add it to our offering plate here in person. Also want to announce that the Bible Searchers Sunday School class will begin meeting in person on Easter Sunday, April 4th at 9 a.m. before service. So if you're interested in starting, please reach out to Charles Long or Ron Matlock to let them know. Also, for Easter Sunday, we are doing a Stations of the Cross. It's called A Walk with Jesus. There are going to be kits available that you will need for Easter Sunday. If you're here in person, you can obviously get the kit that Sunday. However, they will be available to pick up from the church office starting Palm Sunday going forward up to Easter. However, if you need one delivered, please reach out to a member of the children's team. That's me, Laura, Amanda Johnson, or any of us, Brooke Tomlin, and let them know that you need it delivered, and we'll make sure you get it in your hands before Easter Sunday. I believe I saw one more. The nursery will be open starting next Sunday. So anyone that has little that they want to bring, you will have nursery open next Sunday and available to for that for you as well. So you can come in here and worship and know that your child is being taken care of in the nursery. With that, let's pray and begin worship. Creator God, thank you so much for the beautiful spring day outside. Thank you for new beginnings. Thank you for your blessings that you give us each and every day. We ask that you fill our hearts with your word and your love and your understanding. Guide us and lead us in your ways. In your name we pray. Amen. Our Old Testament lesson today comes from a book we don't touch on too often. It's coming from Song of Songs, chapter 2, 10 verses 13. My lover said to me, "Rise up, my darling. Come away with me, my fair one. Look, the winter is past, and the rains are gone and over. The flowers are springing up, the singing of the birds has come, and the cooing of the turtle doves fills the air. The fig trees are forming young fruit, and the fragrant grapevines are blossoming. Rise up, my darling, come away with me, my fair one." And our Old Testament passage is from 2 Corinthians chapter 5, verse 17. Now this means that anyone who belongs to Christ has become a new person. The old life is gone, a new life has begun. This is the word of God for the people of God. Thanks be to God. Thank you. because last night, hopefully, you moved your clock stop. And for the one sitting here, I'm assuming you did, since you've made it here this morning. It's the time of year that we spring forward. We move the clocks ahead, and we lose an hour. Many are going to complain about that lost hour that it takes a long time to recover from. But we, of course, gain some daylight at the end of the day. And that's something I'm really looking forward to, not having to get dark at 5, 6 o'clock. And so this week, that kind of had me thinking about spring, springing forward, spring cleaning, and spring days, especially this week when we had the nice 70-degree weather. You think also about love and what that means. Loving the air on a beautiful spring day, that's a common thing. You think of picnics, playfulness, just being with people you love and care about. And many approach their faith as if they've lost time. They've lost some opportunities and you can never make it up. However, today, I want us to look at that time with love. I want to show you that God's purpose for you in your life is to not look back. Don't regret time lost, but look forward. Always look forward with the love that Jesus gave us. We want to live with and in that love that Jesus intentionally has for us. You see, I believe that this is God's word. I believe that it is for me. It is for my life. And I accept it is mine. And I want to live my life through the love of Jesus. We all should. Being here, that's the commitment that we make, is to live our life in the love of Christ. Now, for me, love has changed over the years. It's very different from when I was in high school or even when I was college. My family has grown. I've gained a sister. I've gained a brother. I've gained nieces and nephews. As a matter of fact, over the last several weekends, I've helped my brother move. That doesn't say love. I don't know what does. But we have moved furniture. We spent most of yesterday decorating my nieces' bedrooms with paintings, and whatever they asked for, they got, pretty much. My mom and my aunt helped plant their garden. Their flower beds, got all those, got everything looked nice and new and refreshed. But when asked, why are you doing all this? The answer is simple. It's love. We love our family. We love my brother and his wife, who is a sister, and his girls. My brother is a prime example of this because he absolutely cannot stand to play tea parties. He can't stand it. It's like the worst thing in the world to him. But when his girls say, Daddy, we want to play tea party. Will you play with us? Yep. They'll play. Because he loves his girls, and he loves to see the joy it brings them. And I'm sure most moms and dads have experienced that to some degree. And love takes all forms. We might not always want to do it or enjoy doing it, but we do it because we love that other person. The love of a father for a child is very special, and God has that love for us. This morning I read a passage out of Song of Songs, chapter 2. We don't really touch on Song of Songs too much because it's a very odd little book in the Bible. It's hard to understand. It's poetry, and poetry is always sometimes harder to understand. Scholars have a hard time understanding this book. They don't always agree with what it means. Some say it's a collection of wedding letters. Others say it's an allegory. I'm truthfully not sure what it could be. And sometimes scripture's not meant for us to completely understand it or label it. But when I was talking and thinking about spring and reading up on it, I ran across that passage. It's about two lovers. We're going to look at it that way today. One wooing the other. One saying, spring's here, come away with me. It's beautiful outside. Come away. Come out and play. Come spend time with me, my fair one. Now, some people get very uncomfortable with that type of language. But it's a passage where we see God as something different than just our Father. We can see Him as a lover in some respects. And that's really hard sometimes for us to look and understand. God is a lover. How does that strike you? How does that make you feel? Do you think that you can see God that way? We know God is love. We've heard that multiple times. And we're okay with that when it's said that way. We know that God showed His great love for us by sending us His Son. For God so loved the world that He gave us His one and only Son. We're getting ready to celebrate that very event in just a few short weeks. Specifically, think about that God wants you. He wants you. He desires you. He longs for you. I think that passage that we read is about God longing for us, wanting us to come be with Him, saying, here, come be with me, come spend time with me, come have a relationship with me. But sometimes we let our past get in the way of that. The first step sometimes in helping us to understand God as the lover is to step over our past. That passage said, winter is past. But sometimes we carry our sin around like a weight around our neck. We don't want to let it go. Our past hurts us, and we don't have a way always of releasing that hurt. We carry it with us. So when God says, come spend time with me, come be with me, we're like, I'm unlovely. I'm ugly. You don't want me. Look at me. You don't want this. We get stuck in ourselves and in our heads and our self-doubt. But all of that is gone. We need to let it all go because God loves us and wants us to be with Him. In the 2 Corinthians passage, it says that if anyone is in Christ, the old is gone and the new has come. The winter is past and the rains are over and gone. Our sin is our past. God is our love and our future. That's what we need to step into and spring forward into. If you've ever had one of those days where everything is busy, nothing is going right, everything is just wrong. And then say someone calls you up and says, hey, let's go shopping. Let's go to the movies. Let's go do this. Let's go do whatever. It helps us to say, yes, let's go, to get unstuck. In fact, I had earlier this week, I had kind of a day similar to that where just nothing was working, nothing was going right. It was one thing after another, but getting piled on at work. I was tired of being in my house. I was over everything at the point. And I got a message from a former youth named Caitlin. Caitlin lives at the beach. And we always talk about making plans to get together and catch up, but it's always a vague plan because you don't really have really any intentions of following through on. Well, Caitlin was determined that day. I said, nope, we're not going to do that. We're going to put it on the calendar, and we're going to do this. You need to be safe. I need to be safe. We're coming to the beach. We made our plans, and it is inked into my calendar, not in pencil, but in pen, so I can't get out of it. It is, that day is hers. It is reserved. And I'm actually looking forward to it, to getting to step away from the mundane, everyday stuff that we go through and to experience something new and different and out of routine. I get to enjoy the newness of going to the beach on a sunny day. So when we get stuck and God says, come, do something with me, do anything with me, take that step. Do that. Because that's when you're going to realize what you're missing. You're going to realize that God's love for you is each and every day. But we get stuck in the mundane, and we get stuck in the past, and we get stuck in the blue. We want to be able to spend the time outside in God's Word. We want to be refreshed. We want to be renewed. To take that time and experience something new. Go outside. The day after Caitlin called, after I got off work the day, I literally sat on my front stoop and put a wreath together. Just to be outside, just to get out of the four walls of my house. And just that hour that I was out there was probably the best time I spent all week. Because it was out in God's country, God's world, listening to His creation. So do that. During this time of springing forward, take the time that God gives you to listen to His creation, to find Him in the new, in the newness of spring, whether it's the flowers or the birds, or it could even be finding something new, like spending time in a bookshop or a new coffee shop. But take His Word with you. Take your Bible and read. Just with you and God, spend time. Maybe it's even your discipleship partner or your, we used to call them accountability buddies when I was working with you. Where we go find someone and say, okay, let's go to breakfast one morning a week, somewhere different, and just spend time in Word together. Maybe you just need to start that up with someone. But find a way to be new and refreshed in God's love. He's calling to you, saying, come away. Come be with me. Go do something. Be somewhere with God. In 2001, a musical talent hit the scene, Nora Jones. She was brand new. Nobody really knew who she was. And her debut album was called Come Away With Me. It featured a number one hit. And I'm going to read the lyrics. And I want you to listen to them and listen to what they're saying. So the lyrics go, come away with me in the night. Come away with me. And I will write you a song. Come away with me on a bus. Come away where they can't tempt us with their lies. I want to walk with you on a cloudy day. In fields where the yellow grass grows knee-high, so you won't try to come. Come away with me, and we'll kiss on a mountaintop. Come away with me, and I'll never stop loving you. And I want to wake up with the rain falling on a tin roof when I'm safe here in your arms. So all I ask is for you to come away with me in the night. Come away with me. It's a love song, but it's a modern-day love song. The passage from Song of Solomon is the same thing. It's saying the exact same thing Nora Jones' song did. But it's easier sometimes for us to hear it from a pop star than it is from God. Because God is saying, come away with me. He wants you. He longs to spend time with you. So what's holding you back from doing that? We often don't think of God as a person. But you know, and as I thought about it, that some of the best times with God are when it felt like He was real and right there physically beside me. When it felt like I could just reach out and touch Him. I felt like I was talking directly to God. Sometimes He's holding my hand, sometimes He's holding me. But those were probably the most strongest times because I took the time to let God in and to open up myself to God. God is our renewal. He's our lover. He's our strength. He sent us His Son to ensure that we could be with Him for eternity. So during this time of spring, how are you going to spring forward? How are you going to renew yourself in Christ? Find a way to feel renewed and refreshed in His love. Find a way to experience His love, whether that's going outside or going somewhere new. But look and listen for the signs that God sends you, because they are everywhere. So challenge yourself. Try something new and see where God takes you. God, thank you for always wanting us to come be with you. We ask that you open your arms wide and accept us all. We know that you do. Lord, help us to find ways to express ourselves and renew ourselves in you and your love. It's in your name. go this week and find ways to go away with God. Find a way to be renewed and refreshed. Lord, we ask that in your name.